folks, Will from MinIO with a how-to on how to upload files to MinIO using JavaScript. And in our video today, we're going to be using Node version 18. We're going to talk about using play.min.io, which is a nice little sandbox we have where you can connect and play around. And also, we're going to be using Visual Studio Code, which is a great little IDE for writing JavaScript, among other things. So let's go ahead and take a look at our code. All right, we have a very simple layout here for working with this code. I'm going to simply be connecting using a play connect. This is part of our MDF, our MinIO demo functions file that I'm importing. And this basically just gives me my connection to MinIO that I can work with. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to use that connection to MinIO to call fputObject. And this is how you upload a file. When you are uploading a file, you need to give it a bucket name. And our bucket name here is JavaScript demo bucket. That bucket's already been created. And by the way, it has versioning turned on. I'll show you why in just a second. Then you need to tell it what the name of the object is that you're going to be putting, and that's the name that will appear in your bucket on MinIO. You also need to give it a file path, and I'm just going to give it the MinIO demo functions JavaScript file. I'm also giving it some metadata, and in this case, the only piece of metadata I'm giving it is this content type application JavaScript, so we know what type of file it is. And last but not least, I have a callback function, and that callback function has an error and an object info. Object info has two fields in it. It has an e tag and it has a version ID. And the e tag and version ID lets you get some idea of the object that you just uploaded. So let me go ahead and run this for you here in my terminal. I'm going to run node index.js and it uploaded the file. There's our success. I have an e tag 83DD0 la 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 4992. And I also have a version ID, C0A6, la 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 la, 4CC8. If I run this again, you will see that the E tag remains the same, but the version ID changes. This is because I have versioning turned on in my JavaScript demo bucket. And so every time I upload the same file, it's going to create a new version in that bucket. The E tag, on the other hand, remained the same, and that's because the file that I'm uploading is the exact same file. If I make a quick little change to this, though, let's just go ahead and throw in a semicolon here. It'll still work the same way. But if I make this little change to the code and then I run that same again, I'm going to get a different E tag. You can see here, AC9B, and I also still get a different version ID. So the E tag and the version ID, they are independent. They kind of track different things. The version ID is going to get incremented every single time I upload the file, but that E tag is really based on a hash of the content. So that's going to change only when the content of the file actually changes. And that's everything I have to show you on uploading a simple file using JavaScript to MinIO. Again, if you want to play around with this, if you want to upload files to play.min.io, keep in mind that play.min.io gets wiped out every once in a while. It just happens as soon as we run out of disk space, we just clean everything out and start from scratch. So I hope you've enjoyed this little how-to. And if you want to connect with us, please take a look at any of the different ways to connect with us here on the screen. You can also reach out to us on Slack using minio.slack.com, or you can just comment on this video and we will respond. Thanks very much, and we'll see you in the next how-to.